we want to evaluate the following expressions involving subtraction. So in most cases, we'll rewrite these as addition problems and then follow the rules for adding integers. But looking at this first example, there's no real reason to rewrite 6 minus 4 as 6 plus negative 4, because we know 6 plus 4 just simplifies to 2. So we can rewrite this as 2, and then minus negative 3 is equivalent to plus a positive 3. Remember, subtracting a negative 3 is the same as adding a positive 3, and then 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. For the second example, we'll write this as negative 11, and then minus negative 2 is equivalent to plus positive 2, and then minus positive 5 is equivalent to plus negative 5. Now we'll work our way from left to right, applying the rules for adding integers. So for negative 11 plus 2, we're adding integers with different signs. And we can see that the negative 11 is going to outweigh the positive 2. So the result is negative 9. So we have negative 9 plus negative 5. And now when we add integers with the same sign, we'll add their absolute values and keep the sign. So this would be negative 14. Let's take a look at a third example. In this step, following the order of operations, we should simplify the innermost parentheses first. So we should simplify negative 2 minus 6 first, which we can rewrite as negative 2 plus negative 6. So negative 2 plus negative 6 would be negative 8. So we'd have 5 minus all of this simplified to negative 8, and then minus 12. Now let's rewrite this as addition. So 5 minus negative 8 is equivalent to 5 plus positive 8, and then minus 12 is equivalent to plus negative 12. Now working our way from left to right, 5 plus 8, that would be 13. So now we have 13 plus negative 12. And notice these have different signs, but the positive 13 is going to outweigh the negative 12, so our sum will be positive 1. We'll take a look at more examples in the next video.